As the horse is well known as a social animal, we have to talk in terms of social cognition. When a horse explores in the social deprivation a novel object, it's really different when a group of horses explore an object, because in that situation in which a group of horses that live together day and night since years, so a very strong permanent familiar group, they interact differently with the novel object. There is someone that goes first to the object, there is another that observes his companion that go to the object, there is someone that go after to the object, there is someone that never approach the object because he is already full of knowledge through the others. So when you talk in terms of a group, a familiar group of horses, you have talk in terms of a web, spider web of connection, in which every horse explore connected with other horses. And this is the meaning of social cognition. So when someone makes some test with a horse in deprivation, in social deprivation, makes some cognitive test, it's a sort of pseudo cognitive approach. A real cognitive approach needs not just horses that live together, because there is also here a difference between horses that live together in the same space and horses that live together because are bonded one to each other and share experience together and live in a cognitive context. Are also here two different. So when you make a test in a paddock with horses that don't know very well each other, is a thing. When you make a test of experience, of cognitive experience, of exploration in a group of horses that know very well each other, you can see the difference. So if we come back to the concept of subjectivity, there is not all the horses sniff an object. Maybe a day yes, and after day not. Or maybe never sniff and prefer bite the object, or prefer use the hoofs to explore the object. So inside the group of horses, there is an expression of subjectivity during this kind of elements, where you can notice a lot of details, also very little nuances between an horse and another, and that give you an understanding of the animal that go very far from the so-called ethology, because ethology very often is reductive about the horse. So it's more than a scientific question, it's important a philosophical question that is also connected with a political question, because every horse have the right to explore in his own way, with his own intrinsic motivation. And it's important also understand that there are horses that study things through other horses. So a horse that sniff an object, for example, or if take with the mouth an object, makes something that another horse's, his companion or her companion, don't feel the need to do, because was the first horse that ever do that. So it's important to understand that, because otherwise we focus too much on the result. If we focus on the result of an exploration, we never see the horse. We never can see the subjectivity of that horse.
But all the other scientists are saying that horses don't learn by observation.
Yeah, but this is a very silly thing. So, For me, science was an important dimension of life. But we have to take care about science because, for example, as they don't have scientific evidence, they declare that horses are not social learners. And this is very crazy. If you ask to someone that have not skills in science but have skills in life, and you ask to him or to her from the street, you ask, but for you horses are social learners, they learn together, the normal person say of course, but for a scientist this is not of course, because they await for scientific evidence, and scientific evidence generally deny the subjective part. So they lose the horse. When you focus too much on find evidence, the part that you lose is the horse, that horse.